Hello, this is Professor Sampson, and today we're going to multiply and divide fractions in your TI-83 or 84 calculator. Now, we already went over simplifying fractions, so it's going to be the exact same thing, except for you're going to have to multiply or divide these fractions. So I'm going to start off using the upgrade in the calculator so you can see the little spots. So that actually, that first one, sorry, it's written like this, 5 over 91 times 13 over 15. So I can go into, if you remember, my alpha y equals, and I can get that numerator denominator. Put in 5 down to 91. Then I need to go over to put in my multiplication. Then I gotta go back and get my little spots again. So I go back to alpha y equals number 1 like we did before. 13 over 15. Now when I hit enter, I'm going to get my answer as 1 over 21. Simple enough. So if I have the upgrade, I can just put them into the little boxes and then hit enter, and then I'll get my answer. Now let's say if I do not have the upgrade. If you do not have the upgrade, the most important part is you must put those in parentheses. So you have to put the fraction, the whole fraction, each individual fraction, in their own parentheses, right? And that's the only difference. So let's say I didn't have the upgrade. I would put parentheses. You always put parentheses around your fractions if you don't have the upgrade, all right? So have 5 divided by 91. Now I need to close the parentheses. Then I'm going to multiply, right? That by, I need my parentheses for this fraction, 13 over 15, right? And then, if I hit enter and I get a decimal, we already talked about to get that change, you gotta hit math, enter, enter. And then you'll get 1 over 21, okay? So that's what you do, that's how you put it in. If you have the upgrade, you may wanna use the upgrade. If you want to type, you may feel like you need to type. So I'm going to do the next one, 14 over 33 times 3/4. So if I use the parentheses, 14 over 33 times 3 over 4, and then math, enter, enter. All right, and so my answer is 7 over 21. 22. Okay. So simple enough, that's all you have to do. If I had wanted to use the upgrade, I could have. Now if you have a whole number, you just put the whole number in. So you can put 7, and if I wanted times, and if I want to use the upgrade, I can go alpha y equals, and then I can put in 3, go down and put 9, and hit enter, and it's going to give me my answer of 7 over 3. Okay? Now we're not going to do a whole video of dividing fractions. The only difference between multiplying fractions in your calculator and dividing fractions in your calculator is that this in the middle turns from multiplication to division. So you're going to put everything in the same way. If you're using the upgrade, because I can just turn this problem into a division problem real quick, or I can rewrite a new problem. If I wanted to, let's say if I wanted to do, and I'll keep it the same, 5 over 91, right, times, let's say, 13 over 25, just make, I mean, divided by 13 over 25, all right, something like that, all right, we would simply do the same thing. If you want to use the upgrade, you will put in 5 down to 91, but only this time when you go over, you would use the division bar, and then you would get your upgrade again, and you would put in 13 over 25 or something. Alright, and then you would get some weird answer, 125 over 273. So remember, the only difference between multiplying and dividing fractions in your calculator is just that the sign here changes. So remember, if you don't have the upgrade, you must always put your fractions in parentheses, and that will keep you from making any errors. Just always put your fraction in parentheses unless you're using the upgrade. So that takes care of multiplying and dividing fractions.